Aster Chrone served as a centurion of the Blood Angels Legion during the Great Crusade and Horus Heresy. Recruited from the brutal world of Saith and inducted into the Legion prior to its reunion with their Primarch, Sanguinius, Chrone's veterancy within the Ninth would be marked by his ability to endure countless grueling battles. His homeworld characterized by tribal warfare using debased methods of violence. As the only recruit to be drawn from the killing fields during his early service, Aster would be regarded as the Ghost of Saith. Bloody-minded and gifted with an incredible resilience, death's call though scarring his face and requiring a mask to be fitted to his jaw, never managed to claim him. Stubbornly surviving the massacres inflicted upon the Legion of old, with the Great Angel's reformation of the Revenant Legion, Chrone lost much of his prestige. Though a capable leader and tenacious soldier, the Age of Bloodthirsty Angels had been put aside in favor of more regal and noble-bearing Astartes. Assigned to the 94th Company and demoted to the rank of Judicia to replace the slain Archaean, Malachi, following the Inkonu campaign. As a warrior marked for judgment, Aster fought ahead of the Blood Angels' advances as the equivalent of the infamous Moritats. Regardless of his change in rank, a chance for Chrone to prove his valor would present itself during the Battle of Cygnus Prime. Resisting the call of the Red First, wrought by the Bloodthirster, Kabanda, Aster led his men to defy the carnage of the Demons of the Warp until their Primarch's resurgence. Despite his capable leadership and continued refusal to die, Aster Chrone remained estranged by his brethren as a relic of a bygone era unbefitting the sons of the Great Angel. Forever an outcast, his fate remains unknown. All that we know is that Chrone never escaped his fate as a symbol of his Legion's ignoble past and reminder of his enlightened kin's failure to contain their bloodlust.